Do you want to know how to get paid to test apps for big companies like Google, Facebook, and Microsoft? Then this video is for you. My name is Michael, and I have tested hundreds of different ways to make money online, and I came across this platform that claims you can earn by testing apps for some really big companies. And in this TesterWork review, I'll give you an inside look and reveal all the pros and the cons so you can find out if this is the right opportunity for you or not. So let's start by going over the basics of what TesterWork is. And this is a user testing platform. So you see, you can earn money by testing apps. This particular one, some platforms are focused on user tests for websites and other things. This one is for apps. And you can see they have 70,000 testers from around the globe, so you can join from many different countries. And they also do offer websites, but the main call to action, meaning like what they focus on, is still apps. So you can see that you can test apps from companies like Facebook, Google, Verizon, Microsoft, Instagram, Evernote, Masterclass, a lot of big companies. So this is definitely interesting. And in general, user test, I find quite interesting. They usually pay decently. We'll talk more about whether that's also the case for TesterWork or not, but it can just be a fun way to share feedback and share your opinions and earn at the same time. So let's then go over a little bit more about what type of projects you can potentially participate in if you join TesterWork. So on the website, I do like that they have something called live projects. So you can go to this and see examples of what they have. This is not always the only ones they have, but this gives you an indication or an idea about what type of projects you can participate in and what they currently have. You see, for example, this one, they have software testers in Switzerland, or a new project for Thai-based testers, or in certain US states. You see, they have something in Brazil. So these are some examples of what it is. But also, if you go to the help section, you see they have more about the types of testers or tests you can participate in, where exactly what you have to do, these exploratory testing, where you need to explore a system to test each component and see if it works. And this is because they need to make sure that different software or apps, for example, works before they release it. So you would just basically have to test it, and then you would get paid for doing that. And you see there's different fundamental principles. I'm not going to read all this, that would just be too boring, but you now know that you can go to the help section and read all about these different types of tests that you have and different projects. But then you of course also need to know, if you think this sounds like something that could be interesting and relevant for you, then what do you need to do to get started? Well, the first thing is to just go sign up. I already did that. You just become a tester and fill out some information. It takes a few minutes. I will then log in now, and then we can see what the next step is to get started. So the first thing, once you sign up, what you need to do is to just log in, and then you will get to a welcome page, and then you have a small test, because you need to understand how these bug reports work, because that is what you will be doing for future tests. So you need to take a test, and you will earn points depending on the different questions. And then if something you do not complete, you will like not earn from it, and you need to have this 15 points to start getting paid tests. So this is something you have to take the time to go through. So you need to just go through that. You just need to go to the next and continue through all these different aspects of it. And you see, if you can move to the next, it describes more about what you need to do. And it's important you read through all this, because if you do not understand this, you will end up failing the test. Yes, you will get a second chance, but after that, you might not get any more chances. That means you will not be able to start earning by using TesterWork. So this is very important that you take the time to go through all this. The whole test should take around 30 minutes. This is not paid, and there's no guarantee you will qualify after you finish it. So that's just something you need to be aware of. It's kind of an application, unpaid application, that takes around half an hour, maybe 40 minutes, depending on your speed. So you need to do that first. And then if you get approved, you will get access to some of the types of tasks that I showed you before. But how much can you then earn? Well, let's talk about that also, because you of course need to know that. And then we will also go over how you can get paid. That is all very important to know. So once you get approved, you just basically need to wait. You see, then they will send you invites to join the latest test cycle. So this means that you don't actually have to keep an eye on the platform. You will get invitations when something is relevant for you. You see, some of the projects are only relevant for certain countries, as I showed you earlier also. So depending on where you live and depending on the clients they currently have, it might be after a few days, it might be after a few weeks, there might be a month or more where you do not get any invitations. That is impossible to say. And that's just important to be aware of. That's why it's always good to join more testing platforms, because in general, there will not be a huge amount of different tests. And if you sign up for several platforms, you will get more frequent tests. I also have a video about some of the best testing platforms. I'll leave a link in the top corner to a video about that, so you can check that out also. But how much will you then get paid per test? Well, that always depends on the project. Sometimes you will get paid per bug you find. So if you have one project and you find 5 bucks, you will get paid a certain amount. Maybe in many cases it can be $5, $10, something per bug. Other times, say like, okay, you need to do this test, it maybe it takes 20 minutes and you'll get $5 for that, $10, something like that. So I can't give you an exact answer to how much you can earn per bug or per test, because it really varies from project to project. But it's not something you can do for a living, and it's not something that will make you rich. You just need to be aware of that. But for a little bit of extra money and to earn it in an interesting way, if you like tests like this, then it definitely can be a method to earn from home and in a flexible way where you're not reliant on a certain schedule and things like that. But how will you then get paid? Let's go over that next. So the payment methods are always important to know before you join any platform where you can earn. First, you need to know that you will receive the payment approximately 2 weeks after the test cycle has finished. So that means like once you invite it, you test it, but that doesn't mean that the test cycle has finished, because sometimes maybe I have a deadline of a week or two or whatever to get enough people to do the test. Once that cycle finishes, then after that, it will be around 2 weeks before you will get paid. So it can take a little bit of patience. You will not get paid immediately. And in case that your payment is lower than the general payout threshold, which is $5, then it will be processed the next time. So you need to earn $5 to get paid. And then you can get paid via PayPal or via Upwork. So in general, you need to make sure to have a PayPal account. That is the easiest way to get paid. So I do like that do pay in cash, but these are the two only ways to get paid at the moment. And you see they even have like, I don't have a PayPal account. What should you do? You should, create one, because that is basically what they recommend you use. So if you don't have that, you should get one. If you can't get it in your country, you can use this Upwork contract potentially, but there might also just be other platforms that are then better for you. So to sum it all up, TesterWork can be a way to earn by testing apps for certain big companies. It can be a fun way to earn a bit extra, but you do need to do it with the right expectations. You will not get a huge amount of tests, and it can take some patience. But if you like this type of work and you are patient and you sign up for several different testing platforms, then definitely it can be a way to make a bit of extra money on the side. I will also leave links below to information about other ways to earn online if this is not for you, if you want to use other user testing or other ways to make money online, maybe we can earn even more. Also, I'll leave some information to that below. But no matter what, I hope this video helped you. And if it did, make sure to hit the like button. And also, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out next time you see a video with tips and tricks about different ways to make money online.